What's up YouTube, it's your boy James back with another video, and today we're going to talk about and discuss the most notable Air Jordans being released in the month of October 2021. Now to be completely honest with you, the month of October is kind of dry. There's not a whole lot on the release calendar from Jordan Brand for the month of October, but that doesn't necessarily mean that we're not going to be seeing some heat drop in October. Now historically, Jordan Brand uses the months where they don't have a whole lot of releases scheduled to do some other things via the Nike Sneakers app, where they release sneakers that haven't yet released on the Nike Sneakers app. They do restocks for sneakers that came out months prior, and sometimes they shock drop sneakers you never thought you would see. Now, two resources that I want you to consider following if you're not already is Solinks on Twitter, which is free, and the J23 app, which is a paid app, but it's only $3. And in my opinion, it's a great $3 investment because they notify you when sneakers do come out that you weren't really expecting to come out. I can't tell you how many times that, you know, they sent me notifications and I was able to cop sneakers because of it. So in my opinion, it is a great $3 investment and I highly recommend them. Now, before we get into all the information about the sneakers that are scheduled to be dropping in the month of October, I just want to give you guys a quick disclaimer that Jordan Brand can push these release dates back, they can move them up, and as we've seen many times in 2021, Jordan Brand does this pretty frequently, so just keep that in mind. Now, kicking things off on our list, scheduled to be dropping on October 2nd, we have the Air Jordan 5 Retro Orange Blaze with a retail price tag of $190. Now, the Air Jordan 5 Retro is not the most popular out of the entire Air Jordan Retro product line, but people who love fives really do love fives and try to cop pretty much every colorway that comes out. Now, when it comes to this one, I think a major mistake from Jordan Brand was not actually naming this sneaker officially a Shattered Backboard. If they would embrace that name, in my heart, I believe that this sneaker would have a lot more hype behind it, and I think that the resale prices going into the actual release would be a whole lot higher than they are right now. Now, the sneaker is still going to sell out, people are still going to try to cop, and they will be wearing this sneaker when they finally do receive it in the mail. If this is a sneaker that you like, I think you'll have a great chance to cop it for retail when it drops on October 2nd. Now, the next sneaker that I want to talk about very briefly was also scheduled to be dropping on October 2nd, and that's the Air Jordan 4 Retro Red Thunder. Now, I heard that this sneaker was pushed back to the middle of October. I've also heard that it was pushed back all the way to December. I haven't been able to find anything with an official release date for this sneaker, so, you know, if this is a sneaker that you're interested in, you're going to want to closely monitor the release date for this sneaker, but in my opinion, this is a must-cop sneaker. It's probably double-up worthy for me, so if you like this sneaker, if you like Air Jordan 4s, you know, definitely keep your eye on this one. Now, moving on to the next sneaker on our list, scheduled to be dropping on October 7th, we have yet another Air Jordan 5, but this time it's a women's exclusive, and they're calling this sneaker the Bluebird, and it will have a retail price tag of $190. Now, it's actually sort of rare to see two Jordan 5s released in the same month, but I guess since one's a women's exclusive and the other is a men's pair, I can kind of see why Jordan Brand is releasing both in the same month. Now, when it comes to this colorway, I believe this sneaker is pretty fire in my opinion. You know, women are definitely going to be trying to cop this on release day, and I think men are too. So I fully expect this sneaker to sell out. Now, if you actually catch an L on this and you wanted it, you know, I'm not really sure right now how resale is going to go. Now, even though this is a blue sneaker, you know, kind of has that UNC vibe to it. You know, normally those do pretty well as far as resale goes, you know, and they're kind of expensive, but you know, women's exclusive sneakers tend to not do as well. They take a little bit longer to mature, you know, so if you catch an L on this sneaker on release day, I think you'll probably be able to pick it up for a fair price if you catch an L on release day. If you want to pick it up for retail, you do have a chance to cop it on October 7th for $190. Now, moving on to the next sneaker on our list, scheduled to be dropping on October 16th, we have the Air Jordan 14 Retro Winterized, and this will have a retail price tag of $190. Now, for whatever reason, and I'm not really sure, Jordan Brand doesn't release that many Air Jordan 14s. You know, I don't really see many of them being dropped. You know, they used to drop them pretty frequently back in the day, but not so much now. I do see a lot of 14 lows being released as like women's exclusives and stuff like that, but not many 14 retros for men. Now, when it comes to this particular colorway, you know, I do like it. I do like the 14 silhouette a lot, but you know, I'm just not sure if this is a must-cop sneaker for myself personally. I think the sneaker will sell out. Do I think that this is a must-cop sneaker? I'm not really sure. I really think I need to see this in person to really get the full effect and to see if, you know, this sneaker is definitely something that you need in your collection or I need in mine. I definitely get fall and winter vibes from it, but I'm just not really sure if I need this sneaker or not. If you do like this sneaker, if you're a big fan of the Air Jordan 14 silhouette, you will have your chance to cop it on October 16th for $190. Now, moving on to the next sneaker on our list, scheduled to be dropping on October 22nd, we have the Air Jordan 36 Psychic Energy. And this is going to have a retail price tag of $185. Now, right off jump, I'm going to be honest with you, this is going to be the easiest cop in the month of October. And, you know, just for whatever reason, you know, no one's hyping up these 36s, you know what I mean? Like, I don't see anybody talking about them or anything like that. Now, much like the 35s and the 34s that we've seen over the past couple of years, some of the colorways do pretty good and they sell out, but most of them, you know, they end up in Nike outlets or they end up sitting on the Nike website for an extended period of time. So, you know, that's not to say that this isn't a nice sneaker. It's not to say that the colorway is not nice. You know what I mean? But if you want to pick up this sneaker, if you like the 36, if you like this colorway, that's going to be very easy to cop it on release day. So if you want to pick it up, it's dropping on October 22nd for $185. Now moving on to the next sneaker on our list scheduled to be dropping on October 30th, we have the Air Jordan 3 Retro Pine Green, and this will have a retail price tag of $190. Now the very first time that I saw that this was going to be releasing in 2021, I thought to myself, I don't really need that sneaker, you know what I mean? But the more I see the images, the more I think about it, the more that I think that this is a sneaker that I'll be trying to cop on release day. Now I know it's just your standard Jordan 3, it's probably going to have just standard Jordan 3 materials, probably nothing really that special about it other than the, you know, the pine green hits on the sneaker, but I don't know, for whatever reason I just really like this sneaker, I like the colorway a lot, and this will probably be something that I'm definitely going to be going after when it releases. I'm not really sure how you guys feel about it, you know, let me know down in the comment section, but you know, I think that this sneaker will sell out, you know what I mean, like I don't think the sneaker is going to sit or anything like that. Do I think it's going to be the hardest sneaker to obtain? Probably not, you know, things seem to be getting a lot easier, you know, the more we're getting towards the end of the year and people are sort of saving up for the holidays and things like that, but this will definitely be a sneaker that's definitely on my radar whenever it releases, you know, on October 30th, or even if they push it back, you know what I mean? I think that this is definitely a sneaker that I'm going to try to cop. But I want to wish you all luck on any sneakers that you want to pick up in the month of October. And like I was saying at the beginning of the video, there's not a whole lot of releases in the month of October, so definitely keep your eyes peeled and your notifications on, you know, for any restocks, shock drops, or sneakers that haven't yet released on the Nike Sneakers app. For whatever reason, you know what I mean, something's just telling me that we're going to see something huge drop that we weren't really expecting, so keep your eyes open. Before you guys bounce out, if you haven't already done so, please hit that like button for your boy. It really does help to put my videos out in front of more people and helps my channel grow. And if you're new and you like sneaker content, make sure you hit that subscribe button and you hit that notification bell so you never miss any content when I drop videos. And until next time, peace.